Well, this was one of the most graphic and gruesome testimonies, hearing about Steven Spader laughing and joking about attacking a woman with a machete. David Cates sat through the entire testimony, remaining remarkably calm and strong.
I heard cries for help, begging, no.
19-year-old Quinn Glover says he stood outside the master bedroom in the Cates home with his hands over his ears as Steven Spader and Christopher Gribble attacked Kimberly and Jamie Cates with a machete and knife. He then went in and saw Jamie, who he believed was dead.
She was on the floor, tangled in the curtains, right by a sliding door.
Kimberly Cates, he said, was still hanging on to life.
Covers and the nightshirt were white, but they were all covered in blood. Most of the blood was around her neck.
Glover spent hours on the stand as one of the state's key witnesses. He said Spader's mood after murdering Kimberly Cates was energized and euphoric.
He said it may become an addiction because he liked the high so much.
Spader stared intently at Glover, Glover avoiding his eyes. Despite the horrific details, Kimberly's husband, David Cates, remained strong.
So you're a pretty creative liar, are you not?
I guess so, sir.
You're able to make up a story?
Yes, sir.
Spader's public defender questioned Glover's memory and had him admit several times he lied to police. Evidence showed to the jury included the knife that Glover says he had with him during the attack and the leather gloves that he wore. The state also presented Steven Spader's rules for the Disciples of Destruction, a brotherhood they say he formed with Glover and suspect William Marks.
The DOD is a brotherhood of men looking to feel part of something worthwhile, to uphold the honor which we each hold dear.